Hey, this is Nate Story with Bright Agritech, and today we're going to talk about the best crops for beginners in aquaponic systems. So what crops to start with is one of the most common questions for beginning aquaponic growers. And it's kind of a complicated question, right? You've got climate concerns, you have, you know, growing space concerns. All of these things are things you should be thinking about. But just about in just about any case, just about any scenario, we can recommend a few crops to start with. One of them is bok choy. So right here you see towers of bok choy growing, and this is a plant in the mustard family. Most of the mustards do really well in aquaponic systems, but we really like bok choy because it grows in hot weather, it grows in relatively cold weather, and it produces really, really nice yields for us. So this is what bok choy looks like growing in towers. We're going to walk around and look at a few other greens crops, herbs crops, and fruiting crops. Lettuce is another crop that grows really well in these systems right off the bat. The one concern with lettuce is that it can have some bug issues, so keep that in mind before you start growing it. Know how you're going to control things like aphids. But this is a romaine here, and we grow a lot of romaine, and we grow some butterhead. One of our more recent lettuce varieties that we really like is one called the Amish Deer Tongue, and it grows really nicely in towers. It's got good flavor, and it's a great heirloom variety of lettuce. Swiss chard is another really great crop. It's really nutrient dense, and people really love it. It's got a great flavor. I will say, though, that it prefers cooler weather to warmer weather. Another nice thing about Swiss chard is that you can do multiple harvests. So here you can see that we've harvested off of these towers for a while now, and we just keep on cutting away the outside stalks, the outside leaves, and kind of the inner crown, the core of the plant just keeps on growing. So that's a really nice aspect to crops like Swiss chard. Kale can be a really nice crop for towers as well. Here we've got some good Tuscan kale, and this has been growing for a little while. Most of this we send out through our CSA. So it allows us to just pick off the outer leaves, let the main stalk keep growing, and we can get a lot of harvest out of this kale over the coming weeks and even months. So another crop that we really like are collard greens. And you can see we've been growing these here for a while. We've been sending these out through our CSA. So we're just picking off the outside leaves and letting kind of that main stalk keep growing. And these honestly we've been harvesting on for several months now. So it's a great crop. It's very nutrient dense. It's healthy, it's delicious, and it's just an all-around great crop for hot weather, cold weather, just about any kind of weather, really. And so this is a great crop for beginning aquaponic growers. Fennel is a great herb for beginners. Now, I will say that it has a really large stature, and you can kind of see how crazy these towers are getting here. But it's a large-statured herb, but it's really delicious. Now, if you like fennel tops, you can harvest the fennel tops for a while without actually harvesting the bulb. This is the bulb down here. It's not a true bulb, but you get the idea. It's just an all-around great herb. It likes longer day length. So if you're trying to grow this in the winter, you're going to have terrible luck. If you're trying to grow it in the spring or the fall, you're not going to have great luck. But if you're in the summer and it's a little bit cooler where you live, fennel can be a really productive, really delicious herb to grow. So there are a lot of herbs that beginning growers, whether you're hydroponic or aquaponic, can grow. They can be really, really delicious additions to your dishes, and they can supplement the flavors of your greens and your other crops really, really nicely. Basil's one of those. This is not, I would say, an easy crop to grow necessarily, but it's well worth the effort. It loves a lot of sun, so wait until you have good sunlight hours to start growing it. You can see this is a brand new tower. It was planted a week or two ago. And, in towers it grows very nicely. In most aquaponic systems it will grow fairly well. There are some issues with it, but it's certainly worth the attempt for all of the flavor and all of the things that it can add to your dishes and to your cooking. Chives are a great starter crop for beginners because they're really productive and they're really forgiving. It takes them a while to get going, so if you plant from seed or if you can take basically divided bulbs from someone's garden, something like that, it takes a little while to get established. But when you're first starting, plant them right on top of each other, and within a few months you're going to have a really dense tower of chives that you can cut again and again and again for years sometimes. Minton is another really nice herb to grow because it's really easy to grow and it's really tolerant of a lot of abuse. So we grow mint, and I will warn you, it gets a little bit out of control. So you kind of want to contain it. If you're growing in towers, you're fine, because basically the towers will kind of contain the roots and it's not going to spread to other towers, something like that. But if you are growing in a bed, you need to be concerned about the mint plants actually kind of spreading out and taking over the whole bed. So it's a very simple crop to grow. It's very tolerant of a lot of different water conditions. And if you drink a lot of mint juleps or a lot of tea, it's worth growing a number of plants of mint in just about any beginning hydro or aquaponic setup. One of the last herbs that I always recommend to beginning growers is, of course, parsley. And this is an Italian big leaf. It's really delicious stuff. It's good in a lot of different dishes, kind of like basil. So it grows really nicely. It's pretty easy to grow. It's tolerant of cool weather, of relatively warm weather. You do got to watch it. It does like to kind of go to flower and go to seed on occasion, especially once it gets real hot. But by and large, it's a really nice herb that grows very well in towers as well as conventional aquaponic systems. So a lot of beginning growers, whether aquaponic or hydroponic, have questions about fruiting crops, things like strawberries and cucumbers and tomatoes. By and large, I tell folks to stay away from things like tomatoes and cucumbers. But as you can see here, we're growing a few strawberries. These were actually just planted about a week and a half ago, and they're coming along really nicely for their age. But strawberries grow pretty well. They grow really nicely in these towers, and they don't get so full-statured that they become a problem. And they're also not quite the nutrient hogs that things like tomatoes are. So even though I know you want to put tomatoes in as a beginning grower, I would recommend you stay away from tomatoes. Learn on the crops that we've gone through today. Learn on things like greens and herbs. And if you gotta do something fruiting, maybe try something like strawberries. So stay away from those really nutrient demanding crops like tomatoes, cucumbers, and of course those kind of large statured vining crops. So I hope this was all really useful to you today. If you have any questions, please feel free to post them below. Also subscribe and check out the Vertical Food Blog. For most hobbyists, you're buying mixed fertilizer solutions. So you're buying a liquid mix. And a good example of it would be something like this stuff.